Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that you please rise, remove your hats, and turn your attention to the flag located in the north end zone. As we pay honor to our great country and to those fellow countrymen who have defended her, and to those who defend her today with the playing of our national anthem.
Here live from Hurley Field. Like to thank those of you for joining us, whether you're watching tonight on the live stream or on CMNtv tonight. We have a really exciting matchup in the OAA Blue.
Kicking off with the Blackhawks.
Taking on the Bloomfield Hills Blackhawks. Berkley coming into this one at 4-0, their best start since 2016 in head coach Sean Shields' third season. We'll get to a little bit more about him in a moment here. And they're taking on Bloomfield Hills, coached by Dan Loria. And we are off and underway. Check that really quick, as we are going to get a flag offside, and that one will be on Bloomfield Hills. So they'll take that kickoff 5 yards back, and we'll do it again. Kicking off, Oscar Jankowski for Bloomfield Hills. So Bloomfield Hills, their last game, they took on Brother Rice. A couple of tough matchups in their last two. They got off to a 2-0 start, beating Troy Athens 21-13, a team that Berkley just saw last week, winning a tight one 22-20. And then in their second game, they knocked off Royal Oak 34-7. As we are underway here from Hurley Field, that one fielded. And here's Dombzalski. And he's going to be brought down. We do have a flag. Check that. That was the safety Mark Heron on the return. He's going to have a decent return out to the Berkley 41. But we do have a flag. And we'll wait that momentarily.
First down and 10 Bears from the 30.
Sorry about that brief delay here, but we are set to go. So it'll be Zach Maurice in at quarterback here for Berkley. We'll start in the I formation. Saris behind Peacher. Maurice with the hard count. Give up the middle to Liam Saris, and he's going to have a good pickup out to about the 37 yard line, a pickup of six, a little over six on first down for Berkley. So last week, the quarterback for Berkley, Ian Dombzalski, injured. He injured his hand during that game. Played the latter portion of that game at running back. And
second down and
reading the quotes from that night, it seemed as if they were planning for Dombzalski to start in this game. But as you can see, Zach Maurice, he took the pregame warm-ups with the first team. And now he is out there. I formation again, 2-wide. Give is going to be to Saris off the right side. Saris is going to be brought down after a pickup of 1, 1.5, and it'll be third and short here for Berkley.
Saris on the carry. Brought down by number 15, Joey Dorsch.
Joey Dorsch.
Gain of 2.
The senior, and on the stop there.
Third down and 1.
So it'll be third and 1 here for Berkley. Jake Domzalski split out to the near side. Berkley once again in the I formation. Bloomfield Hills, they're showing blitz. Give up the middle to Liam Saris. He's got a burst up the middle, and he'll be brought down just past. They're going to mark him about right at the 45-yard line.
So it's a first down
for Berkley. They'll move the
brought
chains.
Down by number 8, Shane Winter.
As they're going to the senior running back, Liam Saris, played mostly receiver in previous seasons, but as you can see tonight, and now they are going to put Ian Domzalski in the backfield. Give to Domzalski. Domzalski trying to find space up the middle, and he's going to be brought down after a pickup of about 4 to the 49. Ian Domzalski, his first carry of the night. Bloomfield Hills, as we mentioned, coming in at 2-2, losing their last two games. Next week they do host Avondale, so this a highly anticipated game in Oakland County tonight, and Bloomfield Hills knowing, hey, if we can take care of it tonight, we have a favorable matchup next week, and that one is going to be brought down for a loss. And maybe just got back to the line of scrimmage, and we'll bring up third and long here for Berkley. That was Liam Saris on the carry once again for Berkley. So a little over 2 minutes, 2.5 minutes gone by here in the first quarter from Hurley Field. A local OAA blog calling this the biggest game at Hurley Field since the regional final in 2015. So here's Maurice under center, play fake, now rolling to his left. Zach Maurice looks like he may want to take off, and he's going to get out of bounds, avoiding a hit at his sideline, and I think he does have the first down. The second on the drive here for Berkley as Zach Maurice shows off the legs a little bit. So it's a 7-yard carry for Zach Maurice. And it'll be first and 10 here for the Bears. So here's Maurice under center, power formation. Give going to be up the middle. It's Liam Saris once again. And he's going to have a pickup of about 2 or 3 on first down. Gonna make it second and long here for Berkley. So Berkley, they're coached by Sean Shields, and Shields in his third year, they went 2-7 the last two seasons, but we were here for a game last year, and he talked about what the program needed to do to get back to where they were in 2015 and 16 when they were making those regular playoff appearances. Here's Domzalski off right tackle. Domzalski with some space up the middle, and he is going to be close to a first down as Berkley continues to pound the rock on this opening drive. But Sean Shields, a guy, he coached this team. He was a part of that run as the JV head coach in 14 and 15. And 2017, he was the defensive coordinator at Madison Heights Bishop Foley, where he's a graduate of. And he's been back here at Berkley now for the last 3 years, and they're now finally experiencing that success that he talked about early on. Domzalski is going to be brought down, but not for another Berkley first down, their third on this possession. So they will move the chains. Berkley yet to go to the air. They did call a pass play. It was a play action pass, but Zach Maurice scooted himself for 7 yards and picked up a first down. Ball is at the Bloomfield Hills 33-yard line. And And the give is going to be to Liam Sears, and he is going to be brought down. A nice stop there.
Sears on the carry.
And it's a short pickup of a couple on first down.
Gain of two.
That was 54 in
second
on
down and
the stop. Do not have a name listed for that number here. But a nice play to come up and fill the hole after another carry from Liam Sears. Maurice under center once again. Three backs in the backfield. And the give is going to be to Liam Sears. Sears finds a seam, but he's going to be brought down. A good tackle in the open field. Otherwise, Liam Sears was looking to get to that sideline.
Sears on the carry, brought down by Dorsch.
And he was brought down by Joey Dorsch. We've already called his name a couple of times on this drive. Now that'll bring up a third and six here for Berkeley. Ball is at the 29-yard line, left hash. We'll see if they elect to go with a Zach Maurice pass for the first time tonight. And we do have a timeout called on the field, and looks like head coach Dan Moria
Blackhawks call timeout.
Of Bloomfield Hills wants timeout here for the Blackhawks. So third and six, 5:52 to go here in the first quarter. Berkeley driving right now. It has been all on the ground using a mix of Liam Sears and former quarterback Ian Domzalski, at least former for the time being. We don't know what his timeline is. As I had mentioned, they thought after last week that he was going to be, or they presumed that he was going to be the starter this week. We saw Zach Maurice taking reps with the first team in warm-ups here tonight. And naturally, he is the guy right now. They have been driving. Maurice hasn't had to go to the air just yet. They have been getting it done on the ground with Sears and Domzalski. And Berkeley, who they haven't used yet, and I think a kid whose name we're going to call quite a bit tonight is Ian's younger brother, Jake Domzalski. So watch out for him. And Berkeley will go to the gun for the first time tonight from the left hash, three wide. Maurice dropping back, and he is going to pad. Peacher was behind him, and then it was off maybe the chest pad. It falls to the turf here at Hurley Field, and we'll find out what head coach Sean Shield wants to do now.
Maurice's pass intent for Peacher is incomplete.
So fourth and six from the 29. They have a good field goal kicker, but I don't know about a 46-yard field goal. 46, 47-ish. Kicker Hunter Robinson.
Fourth down and six.
Been pretty good this year from 30 and in, and that's really all you can ask for as a high school team. So here's Zach Maurice. They will go trips to the right. They're bunched up. Jake Domzalski to the left, split out to the near side. And we are going to get a whistle and a flag. So it looks like someone jumped early. And we'll see who the guilty party is. And judging by the reaction from some Berkeley players, it is
a call against
Bloomfield Hills. So a tough penalty to take there, as it looked like they were going to force Berkeley to go through the air on that play. Now with it being
fourth
just
and
fourth and one,
from the 24.
They can go right back to what they're comfortable with and give it to Sears or Domzalski or perhaps even Peacher, Brandon Peacher, right up the middle. We're 0-0 here in the first quarter, 5:44 to go. 4-0 Berkeley taking on 2-2 Bloomfield Hills. Give to Peacher up the middle, and oh, he is stuffed. I don't know if he got the first down. They're marking him short. He lost maybe a yard on the play, and how about that stop for Bloomfield Hills?
Peacher on the carry, stopped for no gain.
So the penalty inadvertently actually
Blackhawks
works
take over on downs. First down
to
and 10.
The Bloomfield Hills advantage.
From the 24.
As they will get the ball back, they hold, no points across despite a nice drive there from the Bears. And now it'll be Bloomfield Hills football here with just past the halfway point here in the first quarter. So here we go, and we have a treat at quarterback on the Bloomfield Hills side tonight. Number 5, Tanner Slezinski. He is a San Diego Valley, or Saginaw, excuse me, not San Diego, Saginaw Valley State commit. Here's the give to, that's number 23, David Adedapo for Bloomfield Hills.
Adedapo on the carry.
5:22 to go. Short pickup on first down.
Brought down by Pennington.
For Bloomfield Hills. Henry Pennington in on the stop there for Berkeley. So it'll be second and six.
Gain of six.
These teams feeling each other out here early. Again, looking second at some of the preview articles for this weekend's slate of games. This one drew the most anticipation. Here's Slezinski back to pass. He's rolling to his left now. He's looking like he wants to take off, and he will. Sugarman in pursuit. He won't get him, and Slezinski is going to be able to go out of bounds at about the 45-yard line, move the chains for Bloomfield Hills.
Slezinski on the carry. Pushed out of bounds by Maurice.
It'll be right at the 45. It'll be first and 10 here for Bloomfield Hills. There's Slezinski under center. Head coach Dan Loria. He's in his eighth year as the Bloomfield Hills head coach. He's amassed a 27-42 record, and he is the only coach that the program's ever known. We are going to get a false start. That was Andrew Sapersky that moved early on the far side of the screen to the right of the ball. The quarterback
prior to
the
snap, false start. It's a 5-yard penalty.
So it is a false start that will set Bloomfield Hills back. So a tough break after the nice run from Tanner Slezinski, but this is a Bloomfield Hills team, especially with, and we'll see, Zach Maurice, what he's able to do through the air tonight, but we saw in that first drive, they elected to go very run heavy. We'll see if that's an indication of the way things go, but you know Bloomfield Hills is a threat through the air with one of the best quarterbacks in the area in number five. So Slezinski under center, quick drop, looking out in the flats to the right side. He's got his man. That's Shane Winter, and he's going to be brought down at the 38 of Berkeley. It's a 17-yard pickup from Slezinski to Shane Winter. And now Bloomfield Hills rolling on their opening drive. A couple of quick first downs. And we'll see what the Berkeley defense is able to counter with here. And actually, this one's coming back. So the second penalty for Bloomfield Hills on the drive. I actually checked that. Now we're going the other way. So all of the players were going in one direction. It looked like a penalty was going to erase the 12 or the 17-yard pickup from Slezinski to Winter, but this is actually going to take it all the way down to about the, it'll be the 24-yard line, so it's a 15-yard penalty. Personal foul, I don't think we heard the official there. But now we are set to go. So Bloomfield Hills nearing the red zone here of Berkeley. Slezinski under center from the right hash. Oh, and he lost the snap. He jumps back on it, though. I think he gained a yard, a scary moment there. And it'll bring up second and long. After a wasted play there.
Recovered by Tanner Slezinski. No gain on the play.
Ball is on the 29.
Second down and 10.
Berkeley put together a nice initial drive, running the football, but they are stopped on fourth and one on the give to Brandon Peacher. And now Bloomfield Hills with their attack, Tanner Slezinski got one first down with his legs, and then one with his arm, finding Shane Winter. Penalty tacked on 15. It was, in total, a 32-yard play, and now they are in business. Slezinski, quick drop, looking at for Sapersky on the slant, but jumping in front of that one was Ben Maurice, and he nearly had that, and he would have been going the other way. Great
pass
job jumping that route
complete
by the junior, number 10.
Third down and 10.
He was on an island out there with the other junior, Andrew Sapersky. We haven't talked about him much tonight, but he is one of Bloomfield Hill's best receivers and one of the reasons, outside of Slezinski, of course, that their aerial attack has been so good this year. So ball at 24. Trips to the left. Slezinski will line up in the gun for the first time tonight. Or check that they're going to go tight slots. Slezinski looking downfield for Sapersky. And oh, almost intercepted. It was in the hands of Sapersky. He bobbled it. It looked like Mark Heron nearly had it for a moment. Either way, it is an incompletion. And it'll bring up fourth down as... Looking at Tanner Slezinski right now, he's going to his coach, and we'll see what Bloomfield Hills does here on 4th and 10. Berkley had a 4th down on their previous possession. It was 4th and 1. They were unable to get it, and now a similar spot here for Bloomfield Hills. It would be a 41-yard field goal.
From the 24.
And we'll see what they elect to do. Slezinski is coming back out onto the field. So a couple of nice plays by the Berkley secondary. Ben Maurice on second down, and then Mark Heron on third down. Okay, 4th and 10, big play here. Probably the first pivotal play, of course, the 4th and 1, but at this juncture of the game, trying to take advantage. 4 wide, Slezinski gets the snap. Slezinski looking downfield, left side, it is caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Bloomfield Hills. Andrew Sapersky with the grab. What a ball from Tanner Slezinski, and the Blackhawks strike first.
Sapersky is good.
You don't need a ton of, with Tanner Slezinski at quarterback, you don't need a ton of space. He dropped that one in there. From our vantage point, it looked like Sapersky was covered, but credit him for making a great catch, and Slezinski dropping that ball in exactly where it needed to be. And the extra point is up, and it is good.
Extra point attempt
that
by Houston is
Sarah
good.
Houston on the kick, so that will make it
with
7-0.
With 3 minutes and
20
seconds remaining in the first quarter,
so they strike first.
Berkley, no score.
On the touchdown from Slezinski to Sapersky. 23-yard touchdown pass. And there is your score. So 3:20 to go. Bloomfield Hills 7, Berkley 0. So Berkley 0 for 1 on fourth down. Bloomfield Hills 1 for 1. And at this point, with 3:20 to go, that is your difference in the football game. It'll be interesting to see Berkley on this next drive. Obviously, we know that they're going to try to establish
the
run first. Anytime you're playing with
a
backup quarterback, and against a team like Bloomfield Hills, the run needs to set up the pass, and I think we'll continue to see that throughout the game. But I also think Bloomfield Hills is too good, and I think Zach Maurice is going to have to make a couple of throws at some point in the game. And that's Heron back to receive that. Excuse me, Domzalski back to receive that one. Breaks one tackle. We are going to get a flag as he was brought down by Dominic Malassi.
Domzalski on the return.
Near the 25, but we do have a flag.
Brought down by Malassi. Gonna be a flag on the play.
And that may be on number 17, Troy Hastings. He came and grabbed Domzalski by the horse collar. And that may add on 15 yards here for Berkley, but we'll await the call. Nope, they're picking it up. They are picking it up, so ball will stay just outside of the Berkley 25. And that is where
no flag on the play.
Zach Maurice and his guys will take over. So trailing 7-0 here. They did trail 14-0 last week against Troy Athens. Of course, eventually winning that football game. Both of these teams have played Troy Athens. Bloomfield Hills beat them 21-13. Berkley in the I formation. Play fake now rolls to his right. Zach Maurice looking downfield. Overshoots Domzalski. Nobody home. And that will bring up 2nd and 10 here with 3:05 to go in this first quarter.
Pass intent for Domzalski is incomplete.
So that was
second down and 10.
Zach Maurice's first pass attempt here tonight. Not the first passing play that they've called. And the timing just not there with either Maurice or Jake Domzalski there. That one well out of his reach and behind. So it'll bring up second and 10 now here for the Bears. 3:05 to go. Maurice, or check that, that's Domzalski. He's going to take the direct snap. He will find some room up the middle, and he'll fall forward to about the 31. And it'll bring up fourth and four.
On the carry, brought down by Winter.
Shane Winter on the stop for Bloomfield Hills.
It's a gain of six. Third down and four.
So third and four here for Berkley. Zach Maurice, his experience as a junior, had played at the varsity level prior to last week. He was ready when his number was called, and he went out and helped them win the game. And we are going to get a flag thrown. This should be illegal formation, but he was stopped short anyway, so we'll see if they decline. And on the stop there was number 15, Joey Dorsch.
Brought down by number 10, Hunter Neely, for the flag on the play.
Illegal formation. You have to imagine that they will decline, and they will. Check that. They may make Zach Maurice throw the football here. They had him stopped, but it would have been about fourth and two. So you throw him back, make Maurice throw it. He hasn't proven that he can complete passes on you to this point. Still only 2:06 to go, or now 2 minutes exactly, clock running. He still hasn't shown that he can beat you through the air. Bloomfield Hills showing blitz. Maurice play action, quick drop. They're going to set up the screen for Peacher. He's got room in front of him and a convoy. Peacher down the sideline. He is going to go out of bounds all the way past the 45 to the Berkley 46. It's a pickup of 20. Great play call there from Sean Shields. And Berkley has it moving
out. Knocked
out of
bounds by number six, C.J. Jackson.
You just feel like Berkley needed a play like that. Things went so well on that first drive.
Quickly, first down and 10.
Momentum quickly shifted in the other direction. And then third and nine. Good play call there as they find Peacher. And it'll be Berkley football. They have it at the 47. Give up the middle to Liam Saris. Saris with a burst off the right side. And he will pick up about four to the Bloomfield Hills 49-yard line.
Saris on the carry.
Minute 10 to go here in the first quarter. And it was Ferris on the stop there for Bloomfield Hills. Again, we'd like to thank you, those of you joining us tonight on the live stream, or if you're watching this on CMNtv. Big time matchup in the OAA Blue. I'm David Hughes joining you for this one. Just one more week left in this shortened 2020 season for both of these teams, for all teams in Michigan. And that's Saris up the middle, and he picked up a few. And then it'll be one of those odd seasons
on the carry,
where everybody is going to advance to the playoffs. Berkley in a regular season, and probably Bloomfield Hills as well, would have been poised for that with the teams that they have this year. So they'll await their seeding, their matchups, but still two games left to play. Obviously Berkley against a team like Bloomfield Hills, they feel like this would be a statement win possibly for their program. After where they've been the last few years, again, 2-7, 4-14 combined in the last 2 years, they've matched that in four games, that win total this year. Here's Domzalski, and he's going to have a first down, pickup of about five, and that will do it. That will also do it for the first quarter. So one touchdown, it was a Tanner Slavinsky pass to Andrew Sibersky, and the Blackhawks lead it 7-0. Stay with us. You are watching OAA Blue Football, brought to you by CMNtv.
No score.
First and 10. Maurice, the give to Ian Domzalski. Domzalski tried to reverse direction and go up the middle, but he was met. That was number 26, Leo Mina, in on the stop there for Bloomfield Hills. And he got back to the line, did Domzalski.
Brought down by Abdomaldit.
But not much more, and it'll bring up second and about 9.5 here for the Bears.
Still gain on the play, second down and 10.
Second and 10, Bloomfield Hills with a 7-0 lead. As it's Maurice under center, they're again going to go to this power look with three backs in the backfield. It's Saris, Peacher, and Domzalski from right to left. And they use a little bit of deception. It's Saris streaking down, 10, 5, and he is going to be knocked out of bounds. But he got in, reached the ball across, helmet fell off. It's a touchdown. What a response from Berkley.
42 yards and a Berkley touchdown.
A 42-yard touchdown run from Liam Saris. And that will make it 7-6 now. Here early second quarter. We wondered what type of response they would have after the Bloomfield Hills touchdown. They convert the big 3rd-and-9 on the screen pass to Brandon Peacher. And then deception on that play with the fake. And Liam Saris, too much speed. Once they weren't positive who had the football, Saris was off to the races. And now here's Hunter Robertson in to try and kick the extra point for the Bears. Domzalski the holder for Berkley. Hold is down, kick is up, and it is good. So a Saris 42-yard touchdown run. It's capped off by the Robertson extra point.
Extra point attempt by Robertson is good.
And we are tied here from Hurley Field.
I'm David Black Hughes seven.
Here.
Berkley
coming
Bears,
to you live
seven.
Here from Hurley Field. And Berkley coming into this one at 4-0. Bloomfield Hills at 2-2.
Ladies and gentlemen, if there is a Grace Jenkins in the crowd this evening, can you please report
so
to the press box?
Once again, even Grace Berkley's first
Jenkins.
Drive.
Please
they
report to the press box.
Had success, were stopped on the 4th-and-1, but I think so far we've seen kind of what these teams want to do. Obviously, there'll be adjustments throughout the game, but Bloomfield Hills, they're going to trust their quarterback, Tanner Slezinski, again, a Saginaw Valley State commit, and one of the best quarterbacks in Oakland County. And then on the Berkley side, they have a running attack that's gotten them this far to 4-0, and then you combine that with having to play a backup quarterback here tonight, and they have kept it on the ground, and they've had a ton of success. Other than that 4th-and-1 that they didn't convert, and we'll see if we're talking about that in the 3rd or 4th quarter in this one as far as what could have been. But other than that 4th-and-1 that they didn't convert, Bloomfield Hills has had no answer for Berkeley's ground attack, as that one is going to be kicked deep. And brought down just outside the 30, and that is where Bloomfield Hills
Rodriguez on the return.
We'll take over. That was Rodriguez. It was tough to tell from
Peacher.
Here. I am on the field tonight. Usually would be in the press box. So I am on the field. You can see where I'm standing right here just by the field. This is a first for me. Have all my notes. Have my tea. Have a space heater.
First down
all right
box.
Here. Cool to see
30.
All the players right in front of you. The action all taking place right in front of you. But some angles can be kind of tough to make out. That was one of them. But here we go, Bloomfield Hills, a great game so far, a couple of big plays, one from Bloomfield Hills, Berkley answers right back, and now here come the Blackhawks with their second possession of the game. Slezinski in the eye, the give will be to Kobe Reed, and he is going to be brought down after a pickup of a few, that was Adedapo once again for Bloomfield Hills. Not Kobe Reed.
Adedapo on the carry.
And we do have a flag.
Brought down by number 65, David Rollins.
And that was David Rollins, the sophomore on the stop. But
any flag on the play?
We'll await the flag here. Got a few of those. And it's going to be a personal foul on Berkeley. So that will be an automatic first down here for Bloomfield Hills.
Personal foul against Berkeley. Be a 15-yard penalty.
We'll see where they spot it. 7-7, your score. Early second quarter. Here from Hurley Field. see no fans.
First down to 10, Blackhawks.
Any opposing bleachers.
From the 47.
Some on the Berkley side. A lot of work going into making sure that this can be done safely and with friends and family here to cheer the players on. First down for Slezinski, and oh, they lost the football bid. Sarah Houston on the give up the middle. Excuse me, that was number 10, Hunter Neely. Ball fell to the turf. He was able to fall right back on it, though. So it will be Bloomfield Hills football at the 48. Not a bad gain, a pickup of about 5 on first down. It'll make it 2nd and 5 here for
Gain
Bloomfield
of 3 on the
Hills.
Play, 2nd down and 7.
So 9:48 to go. Maybe closer to about 6 yards here for Bloomfield Hills. Slezinski under center once again. Play fake, quick drop. Looking for Sapersky on the slant, and he somehow came up with that. The coverage there from Ben Maurice really could not have been much better. And we're at a point where Slezinski may want to stop trying him. Great catch there by Sapersky. A great ball by Slezinski. But Ben Maurice was right there. And it took an incredible effort there for Sapersky to come up with that one. That's his second catch of the night.
Gain of 5.
To pick up a 5, so it'll bring
down
up.
And 2.
Third and about 1.5. Our PA announcer here said 2, but you can see it on your screen. That is not 2 yards. So third and short, Slezinski under center. The crowd that is here, they're trying to make some noise. Slezinski the give, he's gonna be brought down in the backfield. A host of Bears in on the stop there. Ben Maurice, Cody Wrigley,
Neely on the carry.
Alex Stife all in, and now it'll bring up 4th and 3 here for Bloomfield Hills. Just over 8.5 to go here, second quarter.
4th down and 4.
And it looks like Bloomfield Hills is setting up to go for it. We'll get some substitutions here for Berkley. Guys coming off, guys coming on. You see number 40, John Coleman, coming on there. 4th and 4. Maybe closer to 3. Slezinski from the gun. Looking. Quick curl from Sapersky. He makes one man miss, and he may go. He'll be brought down from behind by Henry Pennington. Good pursuit there. Pennington, such a good and smart linebacker. And a nice pickup. It's a pickup of 24.
Pass complete to Spearsky.
Pending a flag that we do see here near the Berkley sideline. So we'll wait and see what that may be. Ball currently marked at the Berkley 21, and that was far too easy. Sapersky ran just past the sticks, got it, and then a quick burst to get some extra yardage after the reception.
From the 22.
So apparently there was no flag. Either they picked it up or that one fell out by mistake. Here's Slezinski now under center from the 19. Give, and trying to create some space up the middle. And he's gonna be brought down after a pickup of about 5. Not like, that was number 24, Cole Rodriguez, his first carry of the game.
Andy Doppo on the carry. Check that, Rodriguez on the carry. Brought down by a pack of Bears.
So we have not seen much of Kobe Reed.
Gain of 6.
In this game, number 22. That's all. Another
second
one
down
of
4.
Slezinski's favorite guys to get it to, both through the air and on the ground. Well, they'll officially call it a pickup of 6 there. And it'll be 2nd and 4 here for Bloomfield Hills. Slezinski in the gun. 4 wide. Slezinski gets the snap. 4-man rush. Slezinski rolling to his right. We do have a flag caught by Shane Winter. He goes out inside the 5. We do have a flag, though, and with the way that Slezinski was rolling to his right, that's usually indicative of holding, but we'll wait for official word.
Holding
And holding is the call.
Against the Blackhawks.
So a big time break there for Berkley as Slezinski, he can do it from the pocket. You see him getting out there improvising and delivering a strike to Shane Winter, but it will not count as they'll pull it back to the 30-yard line on the holding penalty. So the ball's at the 30. They need the 11.
Second down to 19.
For a first down.
From the 30-yard line.
So Slezinski in the gun once again. Four wide. Malik Pelletier, excuse me, that was Neely to his right. Slezinski looking downfield and is going to be caught by Sapersky. Yeah! Sapersky has it. Yeah! Puts a move on. He will walk into the end zone. Touchdown, Bloomfield Hills.
Sapersky
with number two on the game. This one from 30 yards out, but we do have a flag.
Penalty is against Berkley.
And the penalty was against Berkley. Of course, decline. And it's another touchdown pass for Tanner Slezinski and another touchdown reception for Andrew Sapersky. And Berkley now trailing 13-7. And these two teams, we don't see it often here at this field, but trading scores right now. Neither defense seems to have an answer for what either offense is doing. And that extra point from Sarah Houston is up and good.
Extra point attempt by Houston is good. So 6 minutes and 27 seconds remaining in the second quarter.
So that'll make Bloomfield it 14-7 Bloomfield Berkley Hills here. Seven. With 6:27 remaining here in the second quarter from Hurley Field. So it was a Slezinski 24-yard pass to Andrew Sapersky. That began the scoring here tonight, made it 7-0. Berkley responded right back. It was Liam Saris' 42-yard touchdown run. That made it 7-7 after the PAT. And then just a moment ago, Tanner Slezinski finds Andrew Sapersky on that deep out route. He made one man miss, and that was number eight for Berkley. Ian Domzalski right at the goal line, went by him, scooted into the end zone.
Liam Saris.
And that is where we stand now after the PAT, 14-7. Bloomfield Hills with the lead. And the kick is off. Back is Saris to receive. Catches it inside his own five. Saris going up the right side. Liam Saris breaks a couple of tackles. He is going to be brought down from behind by Dominic Malassi, but a solid return there for Liam Saris.
On the return. Brought down by Malassi.
So Bloomfield Hills leading it now 14-7. And we'll,
first down and 10.
We'll see what Berkley elects to do.
To 34.
And it looks like Ian Domzalski may be in at quarterback here for Berkley. The ball is at the 34, right hash. They're going to go back to that look with three backs in the backfield. This time Henry Pennington is in to the right, and now they are going to shift. Domzalski off the left side, direct snap, and he is going to be brought down, but a solid pickup for Ian Domzalski, and he'll be brought down around the 48-yard line. It's a pickup of 14 on the direct snap run for Ian Domzalski. So head coach Sean Shields, although it would appear that Domzalski unable to play quarterback tonight, Sean Shields finding, and you see that cover on his right hand. So that is his throwing hand. Still unable to go with that tonight, but we'll see if they give it a try at all here tonight. He's back under center once again. Power look in the backfield with three backs. Ball near the 50, and Domzalski's going to take a few steps back once again. Domzalski off to the right. They're going to call the same play to the opposite side. Bloomfield Hills was all over it, but Domzalski is able to find a few yards after he turned it inside. So ball at about the 47.
Domzalski
pick up
a
four on first down.
Abdi Dalmad.
The ball right on that Berkley logo.
Second down and seven.
Just beyond midfield. Second and seven, a little over 5 minutes to go here in the first half. 14-7 your score. Tanner Slezinski and Andrew Sapersky. That connection, the story so far here tonight from Hurley Field, but the Berkley ground game, they have held their own, and they're going to do the direct snap once again. Same play they ran two plays ago. Dubzalski going off the left side. He's going to have another good gain and be carried forward for what appears to be another first down.
Dubzalski on the carry.
And they will move the chains. So a pickup of seven as they're marking it right at the 40. And
first
we will get a Berkley first down. Zach Maurice back into the game at quarterback for the Bears. 14-7. Berkley trying to answer as we approach or get closer to halftime. Under 4.5 to go here in the second quarter.
Berkley calls timeout.
Berkley in no hurry, and we will get a Berkley timeout. So we'll take a brief pause before we wind down for the latter part of the second half. Berkley trying to knot things up against Bloomfield Hills. Stay with us. You are watching OAA Blue Football, brought to you by CMNtv Sports. What they want to do first down, they have it at the 40, and I imagine if you're Berkley, you want to run as much time as possible. You don't want to give Tanner Slezinski the football, I would say, with over a minute 30. You might be in trouble. So for Berkley, continue to run the football, and if all goes according to plan, you're continuing to move the football and chew up clock and try to go to halftime tied. So Dubzalski, they had Maurice in for a moment. And now Dubzalski will go back, three backs to the left of him, and that play blown up. Brought down with one hand, that was number 32, Zane Abdelhamid, in on the stop.
Dubzalski on the carry.
In the backfield.
Brought down by Abdelhamid.
And they went to the well just one too many times there. As that
loss
will make
of six on the play.
Second and 16 now. And they'll have to go to the
second down
back
and 16
to Zach Maurice now. Berkley received the football first in the game. So that likely on the minds of their players as they don't want to give Tanner Sissinski the football back. Maurice, and they set up another screen again for Brandon Peacher. Peacher puts a stiff arm on one man, bowls over another, and he's down inside the Bloomfield Hills 35. Didn't get the first down, but picked up a big chunk. And it will create third and manageable now here for Berkley. But we do have a flag.
It's personal foul against
Bloomfield
Hills.
Had a few of those tonight.
Automatic first down.
This game, not a traditional rivalry or anything. I don't think it's been particularly chippy, but got a few personal fouls, and that's a huge break for Berkley. Goes without saying. They were about to be third and four. Yeah, it was a great play. Setting up the screen once again for Brandon Peacher. I imagine Dan Loria is going to go to the locker room and say, hey, the only pass that's been working is that screen.
First down
and 10.
You need
to watch that.
From the 19.
But now a golden opportunity here for Berkley. They're inside the red zone, right hash at the 19. Berkley will go back to the eye. Trevor Jackson to the right of Zach Maurice. It's Ben Maurice, top side. Gives this to Liam Saris up the middle. Such a good burst. It's like an automatic five every single time. And if he gets past that second level, then you're in trouble. So under 3 minutes to go now here.
Brought down by Bush.
In the second quarter.
Get a ball on the play.
2020 version of a student section right behind me. Not what you would traditionally see, but I'm sure everybody happy to be out here. Maurice under center, they're back in the eye. Give will be to Domzalski. Domzalski has a chance, and he will go in. Touchdown, Berkley. It's Ian Domzalski, a 15-yard run.
Yards and a Berkley touchdown.
And Berkley is an extra point away from tying this back up. So it'll be Robertson in to try and tie it. 2:27 to go. It's a lot of time for Slezinski. I think a moment ago I said ideally you'd want it around 1:30. Obviously, if you're Ian Domzalski, you're not going to fall at the one there. There's no guarantee he'll score. So he does score. Berkley now with an opportunity to tie the football game. Bloomfield Hills does have two timeouts remaining, as does Berkley. On for the extra point. Hold down. Kick is up, and it is good. So
a
15-yard touchdown run
with 2 minutes and 27 seconds Domzalski remaining in the first half.
The extra point is good, 14, and we are locked Bears up once 14. Again here from Hurley Field. So far, this one living up to the hype. As I said, you know, reading around some of the different publications before this one, prior to today, seemed to be the most anticipated game in the area. I mentioned there was a quote, someone said it was the biggest game here at Hurley Field since the 2015 regional final. Of course, Berkeley's going to have to eventually get a stop against quarterback Tanner Slezinski. They haven't really come close to doing that to this point, other than when they had Bloomfield Hills on the 4th and 10. But their offense, and even if they're one-dimensional, and we'll see if things get opened up a little bit more in the second half, Bloomfield Hills hasn't been able to stop that Berkeley ground attack. There are too many guys. When you have Peacher, when you have Domzalski, when you have Liam Saris, when you have Jake Domzalski, who's barely even gotten the football here in this first quarter, or this first half, excuse me, and he's arguably their best offensive weapon. And Robertson's kick is up, and it will be fielded. And here comes Bloomfield Hills now with a seam, and that is Cole Rodriguez on the return. He'll be brought down at the 36, but a decent return, and that'll give Tanner Slezinski decent field position.
Cole Rodriguez on the return.
Here with 2:19 to go. Sugarman on the stop there for Berkeley. So ball, looks like it's at the 36. Ball at the 36.
First down and 10 from the 36.
Trips to the left for Berkeley. One back, Slezinski gets it. Slezinski looking downfield, and that one is going to be caught by Shane Winter into Berkley territory. He gets a block, and he will go out of bounds, but we do have a flag, and that is the danger of scoring when Berkley did. They have not had an answer for this Bloomfield Hills passing attack. We'll see what the flag is, though. They are going to pick it up.
No flag on the play.
So a pickup of 36 yards from Slezinski to Shane Winter. Shane Winter's last reception was brought back on the penalty. Caught it inside the 5, but that one will not be. And now Bloomfield Hills is in Berkley territory. 2:08 to go here in the first half. Ball's on the 28. They have two timeouts. We are tied at 14. Thank those of you again for joining us. Exciting matchup, really, here between these two teams. You have a newer school in Bloomfield Hills. Berkley, obviously, they've been around a while, struggled in recent years. One of the good stories in
the,
not only the conference, but the area this year. Trying to get a big win here at home. Slezinski, quick drop. He's forced to rush out. He's going to throw this one downfield, looking for Sapersky, and just out of his hands. It was Ben Maurice in coverage. And how about that job by Tanner Slezinski? Tanner Slezinski, you don't often see that. rolling to his left, had the ball in his left hand, almost as if he was going to throw it, but it actually keeps it farther away from any potential defender. He switches to the right and gets that throw off. Really impressive, and it went through Sapersky's hands.
Second down and 10 from the 28.
So Berkley, it was good coverage again by Ben Maurice, but this ball placement from Tanner Slezinski, really hard to defend. Ball in the 28. Slezinski will go back to the gun. Second and 10, 1:59 to go. Four wide here. Slezinski gets it. Slezinski looking downfield, looking for Sapersky, and it's caught. Caught at the 10-yard line, a pickup of 18. Mark Heron made the stop, and credit to Tanner Slezinski there. Recognized the man coverage that Sapersky had with Heron and dropped it in, a perfect throw, easy pitch and catch. And they're going to mark that one actually at the 11, so it's a pickup of 17 as Sapersky's big night continues. 1:47 to go, clock still going here from Hurley Field. Bloomfield Hills does have two timeouts. Berkley trying to come up with what would be a huge stand just before halftime. Ball at the left hash 11-yard line. Tanner Slezinski will go under center. They're in the eye. Slezinski, quick drop. And Rodriguez got through one tackle, but then Cody Wrigley is going to bring him down from behind. Haven't talked much about Cody Wrigley tonight.
By Wrigley.
Cody Wrigley, a member of the basketball team. He was the only member of the basketball team last year that was also a member of the football team.
Second down and 13.
Interesting fact, usually a lot of overlap between those two programs. Not here, though. It will be second and 13. Clock still running. I suppose no rush. Ball on the 14. You only have so many plays. You have to imagine if someone gets tackled in bounds here, Bloomfield Hills is going to have to take a timeout. Slezinski under center. Berkley showing blitz. They come with it. Slezinski rolling to his right. There may be a lane to run. It's cut off. Slezinski brought down. And how about that job? That was number 84, Berkley, Aaron Sugarman. It looked like Slezinski on that rollout was going to have a lane. There was only a defensive lineman who didn't have a great angle on him, but Aaron Sugarman did a nice job coming over and cutting that angle off, and it's just a short gain.
Third down and 7.
Looks like he did get out of bounds, so it'll be 3rd and 7. Still two timeouts for Bloomfield Hills. So ball on the right hash. Sapersky to the right of Slezinski to the near side. Jake Domzalski in coverage on him. An interesting matchup. Watching film before this one, those two almost mirrored each other in terms of the role that they had on each of their teams. Slezinski looking for the end zone. It's caught! Caught! Touchdown, it's Shayus Qureshi. And it looked like that he may have gotten away with the push-off. They were trying to the Berkley sideline. They were arguing for it. A huge touchdown right before the half for Bloomfield Hills. Sarah Houston's extra point is up, and it is good. So with 17 seconds to go on a crucial 3rd and 7, Tanner Slezinski finds Shayus Qureshi on a 7-yard touchdown, and the Berkley sideline wasn't happy. They thought he got away with the push-off. They may have had a case. Regardless, we move on, and you look at the scoreboard here, 21-17, Bloomfield Hills, and Bloomfield Hills is going to get the football at halftime. And so now you think back to that first drive when it was 4th and 1, And Brandon Peacher went up the middle, brought down in the backfield, didn't get the first down. And that kind of, Bloomfield Hills held serve there. They went and scored, and they've scored on all their possessions now, leading it 21-14. And Berkley, with just 17 seconds left, they do have two timeouts. But I just don't know if that's enough time with
kicking off the Blackhawks,
the way that they have been successful on offense here tonight.
To receive number five,
we'll see if they try anything. Again, Bloomfield Hills does get the football at halftime, and Tanner Slezinski is on fire tonight. And that was going to be a squib kick. Went through one guy's leg. Sure, Domzalski has it. Domzalski trying to take it out to the left side, and he is going to be brought down. That was Leo Mina. And it looks like Dominic Malassi on the stop there for Bloomfield Hills.
Brought down by Malassi.
So ball on the 37, it looks like. That's where it's going to be spotted. Berkley does have two timeouts, but just 9 seconds to go. You have to wonder what Sean Shields elects to do. The tricky part is Tanner Slezinski is going to get the football to begin the second half, but not sure this is a situation where you can really force the issue if you're Berkley. You may just have to count on the fact, hey, we have to stop that kid that wears number five in white at least once tonight. Domzalski, Saris in motion from right to left. Domzalski off the right side. Domzalski looked like he was going to pick up the throw. 5 seconds left. He is going to be brought down. Clock stops. We have zeros. And we'll see if they go out, if they call the half.
Domzalski on the carry.
Or if Berkley wants timeout.
Brought down by Dorsch.
And that will do it. So the first half complete here from Hurley Field in Berkley, Michigan. The Bloomfield Hills Blackhawks leading it 21-14. They get a touchdown right before the half. A 7-yard pass from Tanner Slezinski to Shayus Qureshi. And they lead it 21-14. Both of these offenses have been red hot here tonight. And we'll see Slezinski again at the other end of this break. Stay with us, everybody. You are watching OAA Blue Football, brought to you by CMNtv Sports. And hello and welcome back, everybody, here live from Hurley Field. I'd like to thank those of you for joining us. My name's David Hughes, bringing you OAA Blue Football here today from Hurley Field. Berkley will enter the second half trailing 21-14. A touchdown right before halftime. It was Tanner Slezinski finding Chase Qureshi on a 7-yard touchdown. And it'll be Slezinski getting that football back when we resume here as we are about set for kickoff. Here in the second half, the night has chilled considerably since opening kickoff when the sun was still partly out here in Berkley, Michigan. As it'll be Robertson on to kick now here for the Bears. He gets his running start and we are off here in the second half. That one fielded by Rodriguez. Rodriguez is going to be brought down shy of the 30. And on that stop there for Berkley was number 17, Ryan Krause, the junior.
Rodriguez on the return. Brought down by number 17, Ryan Krause.
So out now will come the Bloomfield Hills offense. They were 3-for-3 in that first half. 3 possessions, 3 touchdowns, all came by way of the air from the arm of Tanner Slezinski. 2 were to Andrew Sapersky, and then the more recent one was to Chase Qureshi from 7 yards just before the conclusion of the second half, or of the first half, second quarter. So here we go. Slezinski under center. Play fake off the right, or excuse me, they will give there to number 23, David Adedapo. And he picked up about 1 to the 30. Make it 2nd and 9 here for Bloomfield Hills. Bloomfield Hills trying to move over 500. This was a program.
Number 81, Alex Steve.
The last 2 years, similar spot as Berkley, 2-7 in the last two seasons.
Second down to nine.
So same as Berkley, they're in the OAA blue this year after moving down. Again, their schedule, they beat Athens to open it 21-13. Beat Royal Oak 34-7. We'll be there next week at Royal Oak. Royal Oak not having a great season. Lost to Rochester. How about that Rochester offense? Lost that 42-20. And then last week they lost to Brother Rice 43-7. Here's Slezinski now moving to his left. Puts it in his left again. And you see it work out perfectly there. And he goes up the sideline, turns it into a positive play. But when he did that at the end of the first half, I mentioned how it could come into handy if you have a defender that's approaching you.
Knocked out of bounds.
And
by
putting that ball into his left there, he was able to keep it far away from the Berkley defender that was running up on him. And it ends in a positive play. It looks like it's going to be 3rd and 1 here after a pickup of about 8. So ball just outside of the Bloomfield Hills 38. It's on the left hash. Berkley trying to get a big stop here. Slezinski did get out of bounds. Our clock is stopped here at 10:53. So a jumbo set now here for the Blackhawks. First time that we've seen this from them tonight. Slezinski, give. And he is not going to get the first down. A good push from that Berkley defensive line. Leading the charge was Cody Wrigley. And it was Hunter Neely who they gave the football to. There was nothing doing, and they are going to give him a spot that would indicate a 1 yard loss officially, and Bloomfield Hills is gonna bring on the punt team here. So how about Berkley? They go that entire first half without being able to get a stop, and then they force a 3 and out right away here in the second half. And that punt, and it looked like Oscar Jankowski hit that off the end of his foot. It takes a Bloomfield Hills bounce, though, so it won't be a bad punt in terms of net. And it'll be downed at the 29. So all things considered, not a bad job there from Oscar Jankowski. And the Berkley offense will come back out here with an opportunity to tie the football game. So the defense does its job. Big time push from that defensive line on 3rd and 1. That charge was led again by Cody Wrigley. They were in the Bloomfield Hills backfield, and now Berkley with an opportunity here to knot things up. We get a look at their sideline. And a great year that it's been for the Bears, as we mentioned, or as I mentioned earlier in the broadcast. 2-7 in each of the last two seasons, both of these teams with identical records. But they meet here tonight as kind of the eyes of the county are on this game to see if Berkley can continue the magic that they've had this season. Give to Domzalski, and he is going to pick up one, not much more. He's brought back, but forward progress will give him the 30 and about a yard.
On the carry, brought down by Dorsch.
So, 2nd and 9. Zach Maurice coming back into the game for Berkley. Maurice has only attempted a couple of passes tonight. He has 2 completions, both on screen passes, to Brandon Peacher. Peacher is in the game now. We'll see if they talked about that screen pass at all during the break. I formation. Play fake. Maurice rolling to his left, looking for somewhere to go. Escapes one man, and he's going to be brought down from behind. That sack was from Cole Rodriguez, number 24. The junior got in, and it's going to bring up 3rd and long now here for Berkley. So how about these two defenses to open up the third quarter here? Almost nobody could get a stop the entirety of that first quarter. In fact, our last 5 possessions for either team all resulted in touchdowns. And now here we are, early second half. Bloomfield Hills went 3 and out, and now Berkley, unless they're able to pick up 13 yards here, they're going to do the same. Third long from the 27. They need the 40 for a first down. Maurice under center in the eye. Play fake. Zach Maurice drops back. Rolls to his right. Nowhere to go with it. He's going to get rid of it. Lucky that one wasn't intercepted. Incomplete. It was intended for Aaron Sugarman. Zach Maurice does a nice job of not taking the sack and also throwing it into a somewhat safe place. So a couple of three and outs consecutive here to open the third quarter. And now it'll be Hunter Robertson into punt here for Berkley. So back deep for Berkley will be Cole, or for Bloomfield Hills, excuse me, will be Cole Rodriguez, the man who had the sack on Zach Maurice just a moment ago. Robertson waiting for the snap, and we have some early movement. And we will await the call. It looked like there was some early movement up front, though, for Berkley, and that is what the call will be.
False start against Berkley. It's a 5-yard penalty.
So a 5-yard penalty. It'll make it fourth and 18 now. Ball is at the 22. Left hash. Robertson back to try and get a punt off this time. Decent snap. Punt. Not a bad one. It's going to fall at right at the 50. Takes a couple of Berkley bounces, and it'll be down at the 44-yard line, as that is where Tanner Szczynski and the Bloomfield Hills offense will come back out. So 8:01 to go, 21-14 your score. Szczynski tonight, 3 touchdown passes. Andrew Sapersky has 2 of those receptions. Chase Qureshi has another one. On the Berkley side, Liam Saris with a 42-yard touchdown run, and then Ian Domzalski, the quarterback up until the second half of last week's game. They thought he was going to be good to go tonight to play a quarterback. He still has a wrap on that right hand. They've done a nice job of getting him involved, but Zach Maurice is your guy at quarterback tonight. And a give up the middle there. That looked like it was to Joey Dorsch. And in on the stop there was number 20, Henry Pennington.
Brought down by Pennington.
So he got about back to the line, not much more. It will stay
second down
at the 46. They need the Berkley 44 for a first down. It'll be second and 10. Szczynski will go back under center. Szczynski looking out in the flats. He's got Sapersky. Sapersky with a burst up the middle of the field. And he lost the football. He lost the football. It's on the ground, and I think Berkley almost had it. Number 54, Jalen Spratt, was right there. But how about that from Nick Krupa? He fell on it. Nearly disaster for Bloomfield Hills. And a big gain from Szczynski to Sapersky. He put the ball on the turf, and Berkley had a few guys in the area. But how about Nick Krupa, the senior, whose name we haven't called a ton here tonight, makes potentially a game-changing play. So first down from the 26. 6:53 to go here, third quarter. Bloomfield Hills trying to make this a 2-possession game. Ball on the turf again. Berkley picks this one up. Berkley is on top of this one. There was trouble with the handoff between Szczynski and Adedapo. It fell to the turf, and the junior, Alex Stipe, recovers the fumble. Give it back over to Berkley. How about that? 2 plays and 2 consecutive fumbles for Bloomfield Hills. The senior, Nick Krupa, was able to bail his team out once, and they couldn't find anybody to do that again. You just can't put the ball on the turf on back-to-back plays. Playing with fire. They got burnt there. Berkley now, their offense
first
back on
Berkley,
the field. Ball spotted at the 27. We have 6:45 to go here in the third quarter. Big break for Berkley there. Maurice Give to Saris, and he is going to be stonewalled. Nice job there. That was Mark Bland, the senior on the stop, number 56. No gain there, so now Berkley all of a sudden having a tough time establishing the run. Still early, they've only run just four offensive plays here in the second half. But those lanes that were there in the first half not opening up quite in the same way here in the second, at least to this point. We're nearing the halfway point of the third quarter, a little over 6 minutes to go. Power formation from Berkley. Maurice, the give to Saris. Saris off the left side, and that was Bland again. Excuse me, that was 54, not Bland. 54, who we do not have a number or name for. I apologize.
Brody Snyder.
That is Brody Snyder, so we get word from the PA. 54, who has a few tackle for losses. Usually wears 33, at least on the roster.
Two.
He is
third down and eight.
54. That's a senior. Senior linebacker who's had a heck of a game tonight. Glad we can call his name out now. Under 5.5 to go here. Big third and eight. Berkley not trying to not squander the opportunity that they were just given. Four wide. Maurice from the gun. Maurice looking for Domzalski on the out route. He has it, putting a stiff arm on. He is going to be brought down at the 36. They're going to give him forward progress to the 36. Oh, and then he takes a dive.
Pass to Peter Domzalski, brought down by Sapirski.
And he, I think, is going to be a yard short of the first down. We do have a flag. I don't see it, but the PA announcer here just informed myself and the rest of the crowd. And it looks like he was right. It's a face mask.
Foul against Bloomfield Hills, 15-yard penalty.
So Domzalski, Jake Domzalski, after that run, he got up, looked like he was asking for some type of flag, didn't see it in real time, and then he kind of took a fall as if to try to prompt another flag, an unrelated one. A little bit confusing, but they're going to get the first flag. It's a face mask. So it's a big time first down. Third and eight, they convert. It would have been fourth and one. Would have been an interesting decision. It's one they don't have to make. Ball at the 49. Maurice gets the snap. Zach Maurice, they're going to set up that screen again for Peacher. He's got blockers in front of him. Brandon Peacher trying to go to the outside, and he's going to be forced out of bounds. Sapirski on the stop. Decent pickup, though, of about 7 or 8 on first and 10. So Berkley,
knocked out of bounds by
the only play that is. They've had success with through the air is that screen pass. They continue to go to it. Good call there. It worked out. Brandon Peacher.
Second down and three.
His third reception of the game. It'll bring up second and three now. They have it on the Bloomfield Hills 42-yard line, left hash. Domzalski is in at quarterback here. Peacher in the backfield at his right hip. Saris in the slot to his right. He'll come in motion from right to left. And they're going to run it off to the right side. Domzalski couldn't find anywhere to go. He's going to lose about two there, and it'll bring up third and five now.
Domzalski on the carry.
With 4:40 to go here in the third quarter.
And Mitchell.
So it'll be interesting to see where Sean Shields goes here. I think if you had just called the screen, you may elect to go with that play here. They did, or maybe the fact that they just did creates even more deception with them not expecting it again. Fourth and five, though, third and five, excuse me, they've had trouble through the air here tonight. Domzalski, they're going to run it straight up the middle. Domzalski trying to find space to the outside. Domzalski is going to be brought down. He picked up a few yards. They tried to get Domzalski in space to the far side of the field.
Domzalski on the carry.
It looked like he may have had a lane for a moment. It quickly closed up. And now fourth and short here for Berkley. And the decision that they were able to avoid a couple of minutes ago because of a flag, they'll have to face here. Hunter Robertson is on the bench for Berkley. So they appear, at least, to be going for it.
Fourth down and three from the 42.
Well, you do see your fair share of quarterback cooch punts at this level. Domzalski is in the game.
four wide, Peacher to his right. Ball at the 42, they need the 39 to keep this drive moving. Kimzalski trying to get him on a hard count. They're gonna go straight up the middle on a QB blast, and this is going to be close. The spot will give him the first down. Ball appeared to be across. The spot appeared a little bit generous, but I think he did have the first down. A big pickup for Berkley there.
First down and 10.
So just over 3 minutes to go here in the third quarter. It's been fast moving. The points have come to a halt. They had just had one possession in that first half in which there wasn't a touchdown. And in this half, we've already had a couple of punts, one from each team, and then a Bloomfield Hills turnover. Give up the middle to Ian Dubzalski. He shakes off one defender, and he'll be brought down all the way around the 25-yard line.
Dubzalski on the carry.
They're going to mark it about 26, called a pickup of 12 on first and 10. Tackle made there by Joey Dorsch.
Gain of 12 on the play.
Whose name we have been calling a ton tonight.
From the 26.
Under 2.5 to go here, third quarter from Berkley. They're trying to knock things up right now, trailing it 21-14. No points yet here in this third quarter. Maurice under center. Maurice, give to Liam Saris. Saris off the left side, he's past the 20. Saris brought down by Ferris, and not before Saris is able to get a first down though at about the 16. So move the chains again. Well, I'll tell you, once Liam Saris gets a burst and has room for that outside, it's lethal for opposing defenses. Credit Christian Ferris there, the senior defensive back,
first
getting over
10
there and making
the
stop. So first down from the 16. Things certainly getting interesting here from Hurley Field. Berkley trying to tie this thing up as we approach the fourth quarter. Maurice to give to Saris off the left side once again, and that one is going to be cut off. Great play from Leo Mina coming up and making the stop. Pickup of a
Saris
couple
on, the carry.
On first down.
Brought down by Jackson and Mina. Gain of one. Second down and nine.
Leo Mina, the senior.
From the 15.
So 1:39 to go, third quarter. We have a Bloomfield Hills student section. Makeshift to the right of me. They've been making a ton of noise. Here's Maurice under center. Maurice, the give to Ian Dubzalski. Dubzalski fighting for extra yardage. And they're gonna blow that one dead finally after a pickup of about 3 or 4.
Dubzalski on the carry.
He was down and
brought down by Ferris.
Antonio Mitchell picked up the football, went the other way, but Dubzalski will be called out. So it will bring up a third down here once again for Berkley.
Third down and 7.
Ball is on the 13. It looks like they need the 7 for a first down. I would call it 3rd and 6 here. Maybe 6.5. Somewhere in that range. You see the sticks on your screen. That's where Berkley has to get here. Maurice under center. There is a receiver that's outside of your screen to the bottom. Maurice, play fake. Looking. They're going to set up a screen once again for Brandon Peacher. Can it work again? It looks like it will. Touchdown, Bears. For the fourth time in this game, they go to the screen pass. We did get a late flag. Well, after the play was over, we'll wait to see what that was. Nothing jumped out. So the official rules it a touchdown. And now they will come together. And this may push them back on the extra point. You get a look at the official. Waiting for the call here. Didn't look like we had any official signal, or at least not one that I caught in real time. Perhaps an excessive celebration penalty, I'm really not sure. That touchdown comes with 13 seconds left in the third quarter, though. And now they're a Hunter Robertson extra point away from tying this thing up. But this extra point's going to be moved back to the 17. So some type of personal foul after the play. And this is going now, that looms large, because this is going to be a 30, if they kick it, this is going to be a 34-yard extra point for Hunter Robertson. Kamzalski in to hold. Bloomfield Hills is going to keep a couple of guys back. So Robertson, a good kicker, but this is tough distance. Snap is down. Dabzalski has it. The kick is up, and it is good. Robertson to tie the game from 34 yards out makes it 21-21. A big-time kick. You get a look at the score there. All six PATs, three on each side, have been good tonight. You don't often see that in high school football, but a pair of good kickers. Sarah Houston on the Bloomfield Hillside. And how about that one from Hunter Robertson just a moment ago? He drills that one to tie things up at 21 with 13 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. Should be a fun finish here from Hurley Field as Berkley and Bloomfield Hills battling it out. Playoffs start in a couple of weeks. Season finale next week. These two teams battling it out.
Berkley number 24, Hunter Robertson.
For supremacy in Oakland County.
Back to receive for Bloomfield Hills, number 24, Cole Rodriguez.
So Cole Rodriguez is back deep to receive for Bloomfield Hills. 21-21 your score. Robertson's kick. And that one is going to be fielded by Sapersky, or excuse me, that's not Sapersky, that's Qureshi. He's brought down at the 30. So force back.
Qureshi on the return.
At the 30, exactly.
Tripped up by Steve.
7 seconds to go. So unless Bloomfield Hills scores on this play, they would have went the entire third quarter without scoring after having not been stopped at all in the first half. 21-21. Berkley gets it where they want
first
it, headed to
Blackhawks
the fourth.
From the 30.
They forced a Bloomfield Hills turnover. They forced a Bloomfield Hills punt. Maybe not a forced turnover. Miss exchange on the staff. Here's Slezinski, though. He's got the arm to get them out of this. Pennington in pursuit of Slezinski. Slezinski gets rid of it. And it is going to be incomplete. Pass was intended for Sapersky. And the clock hits zeros on the third quarter here from Hurley Field.
So
folks, we have a good one.
At the end of three quarters to play, Bloomfield Hills 21.
Looks like they weren't going to reverse field for a minute, but now
21.
They realize they need to switch it up. So we have played three here from Hurley Field, and we are tied heading to the fourth quarter. Stay with us. You are watching OAA Blue Football, brought to you by CMNtv Sports.
Second down and 10 from the 30.
Hurley Field, second and 10. Okay, he's joining for this one. We are on the field now. Slezinski gets the snap. Slezinski rolls to his right. That one's intercepted. It's intercepted. John Coleman down the sideline makes Slezinski miss, and he takes it into the end zone. A rare mistake from Tanner Slezinski, and John Coleman with the pick six, and Berkeley's out in front.
Pass intercepted by number 40, John Coleman.
The sophomore, John Coleman,
touchdown.
Picks off the senior Saginaw Valley State commit, Tanner Slezinski, and he takes it in. And just like that, Berkley has the lead on Bloomfield Hills' second turnover of the second half. 27-21. And I just heard Sean Shields say, hey, we got to keep getting turnovers. It has certainly swung the game in this second half. Robertson, this extra point won't be quite as difficult as the last one. Snap is down, and the kick is up, and it is straight through. So, a John Coleman interception return for a touchdown, and Berkley now 14 unanswered, and they lead it 28-21, outscoring Bloomfield Hills 14-0 so far in this second half. And it's cliche, but quarterbacks, they have to have short memories. So we'll see what Tanner Slezinski's response is when he comes back out on the field in just a moment here. Take a quick moment to look at some scores in the area. Sterling Heights-Stevenson is up 35-14 on Grosse Pointe South, 7:34 left in the third quarter. Clarkston leads Seaholm 28-7. There's 9:46 left in the fourth quarter there. Looks like we don't have a final yet. End of three with Rochester and Ferndale. Rochester leads that one 34-8. Macomb County action. Lance Cruz leading Lakeshore 36-0 at the end of three. And we'll get some more in a bit. As high school football winding down, at least regular season high school football in the last couple weeks, playoffs coming up. And how about this from Berkley, 28-21, a pick six a moment ago from John Coleman, the sophomore. And now a little bit of trouble here for Bloomfield Hills. Fielding that one is 85. Again, not listed on the roster. I do apologize. He has a pickup about to the 24. So not a bad return given the circumstances. He had to field that one retreating into his own direction. And they will start with it at the 24. So here comes Slezinski back out onto the field. He threw a pick six on his last play. But we know
first down and 10
that this is a Bloomfield Hills offense that has the ability to strike and strike quickly. So here we go. Slezinski. He has Dorsch and Rodriguez, it appears, in the backfield. Slezinski. Licked his fingers, then he got hit from behind. Oh, they're going to rule an incomplete pass. I don't know about that one. We do not have the luxury of Berkley being able to challenge here. And I have a spectator next to me saying it hit his hand. It came out of his hand before his hand went forward. That appeared to be the case to me as well. And Bloomfield Hills has to be careful here. They put the ball on the ground twice on consecutive possessions. They threw an interception and then a near fumble there. Have to take care of the football if they want to come back in this game. 11:34 to go, fourth quarter. Slezinski in the gun. Four wide. Slezinski gets the snap. They're going to set up a screen pack for Cole Rodriguez. Rodriguez will be brought down at the 30. So he picked up about six.
Pass is complete to Rodriguez.
And it'll bring up third and four. They need about 33-34 for a first down here.
Third ball, down and four.
Ball just outside of their own 30. You see it there. So you wonder what Bloomfield Hills would do here if it came to a fourth down. Defense has had trouble stopping the run. They've looked better in this half on defense, but turnovers have been the demise so far in this second half. That one good for a first down to Shane Winter. Winter out of bounds at about the 39-yard line. So just a quick curl route to Winter. Slezinski on the money with that. And Bloomfield Hills will move the chains down.
Number 20, Henry Pennington.
Henry Pennington forced him out of bounds. So ball will be
from the 40.
They'll mark it right at the 40. So about 60 yards to go to try and tie this thing up. 10:44 to go here, fourth quarter. A John Coleman interception return for touchdown put Berkley up 28-21. Slezinski rolling out, and he overshoots both Sapersky and Dominic Malassi. Not sure who it was intended for.
Sapersky is incomplete.
And it'll bring up second and 10, clock stop with 10:40 to go.
Second down and 10 from the 40.
So Bloomfield Hills, they'll get Avondale at home next week. Avondale taking on Royal Oak tonight. Royal Oak, where we will be next week. That one will be live streamed and then shown on CMNtv afterwards as well. Ball at the 40, left hash. Slezinski under center. Slezinski, quick drop. Oh, and he got it knocked away from behind by Saris, and they're going to fall on top of it. Number 66, Cameron Coleman for Bloomfield Hills fell on it. Liam Saris came flying off the edge there. Tanner Slezinski didn't have a shot at seeing him. Knocked it free. It looked really similar to the last one that was ruled incomplete. That one ruled a fumble, but Cameron Coleman able to fall on it for Bloomfield Hills. So third and 21. Now for Bloomfield Hills, we'll see what the approach is, if they try to get a chunk here and make it fourth and manageable, or if they go for it all out. 9:50 third quarter. Bloomfield Hills trailing. Slezinski looking downfield. It's caught by Shane Winter. Shane Winter has it and a first down on third and 21. All the way out to the 50, it's a pickup of 21. On third and 21. And they'll move
21 yards.
They're going to move the chains.
First down
and Slezinski, he throws the interception on the last drive. Probably fumbled it twice on this drive. But then you see what he can do on a third and 21. Rolls out, hits his guy on the run in stride. A huge conversion there for Bloomfield Hills. 9:41. Ball at the right hash. Slezinski looking to throw. And that one is going to be caught by Sapersky. Sapersky trying to turn it upfield now. Made Pennington miss. Sapersky being drugged down from behind by Dzimzalski. He'll be down at the 31-yard line. It's a pickup of 19 from Andrew Sapersky.
Pass complete to Sapersky.
So 28-21, another first down. They're going to actually mark that
at the
32. It's an 18-yard pickup as Andrew Sapersky continues to have a day here for the Blackhawks. Slezinski has Rodriguez and Dorsch next to him in the backfield. Slezinski uses a little pump fake, looking deep. That one is intended for Sapersky, but a nice job in coverage there from Ian Dzimzalski. He was with him stride for stride, and there just wasn't an opening. 8:52 to go here in the fourth quarter. Second and 10, the ball is on the Berkley 32.
Second down and 10 from the 32.
Last year, Tanner Slezinski, he threw for 23 touchdowns, 1,900 yards. He replaced the guy who ended up going on to Ball State, John Paddock. Paddock, he was their backup last year at Ball State. Slezinski actually credited Paddock with teaching him how to throw a football at the high school level, as we are going to get a timeout, I believe.
Bloomfield Hills calls timeout.
And that will be called by Bloomfield Hills. So we'll keep it right here. Thank you for joining us tonight. Great game. It's lived up to all of the hype. I was excited coming out here tonight. Berkley, Bloomfield Hills, a couple of really good football teams. Berkley trying to hold serve for what would certainly be their biggest win probably since the last time they won a playoff game 4 or 5 years ago. It would be a massive to get this win. A really good quarterback here in Tanner Slezinski, as they've forced him to make mistakes here tonight. Just on this drive, we had a couple of fumbles. One was ruled incomplete. It looked to be a fumble. Fumbled again. They were able to pick it up. And then on third and 21, they get the big conversion to Shane Winter. And now we're sitting here, 8:52 to go. Berkley trying to hold on against Bloomfield Hills. So it's been Slezinski, it's been Sapersky on the Bloomfield Hills side tonight. We've seen quite a bit of Shane Winter. One thing that Bloomfield Hills has struggled doing is getting the running game going. We haven't seen much of Kobe Reed or really any of Kobe Reed, any of in this game. Not sure what the reason for that is. He hasn't played here tonight, though. So here's Slezinski. He's got four wide. Cole Rodriguez to the right. Slezinski gets the snap, looking downfield. Now rolling out, looking, and that one is going to be caught by Shane Winter on a dive. All the way down to the five, it appears.
Slezinski's pass intended for Winter is complete.
A 27-yard pickup. And this appears inevitable now. You assume that they'll go with the extra points with this much time remaining, 8:43, and try to hold on defense to get Slezinski the football back. So first and goal from the five. Shane Winter has been the guy on this drive. And now we're going to get a flag. Someone came off late. It's going to be too many men on the field, I
prior
think.
Prior to the snap, penalty against Bloomfield Hills. It's a 5-yard penalty.
So that'll set him back 5 to the 10. So it'll make it first and goal from the 10. A little bit harder. Space is so condensed in that area. Harder to throw. Harder to punch. Just punch it in. When you have first and goal at the 10 as well. So we'll see how the Blackhawks play this.
It's first down and goal from the 10-yard line.
So here we go. First and goal. I formation. Give to Rodriguez. Rodriguez up the middle, and he's brought down from behind. A touchdown saving tackle there, and that was number 16 for Berkley, Colin Linehan.
Rodriguez on the carry. Brought down by Linehan.
Pickup of about 6 or so. It'll make it second and goal
from the four
here. Clock running under 8.5 to go. Berkley trying to hold and maintain their lead. It looked like they were going to for a moment. They had Bloomfield Hills at 3rd and 21 in their own territory. But a conversion from Bloomfield Hills from Slezinski to Winter. Two 20-yard receptions on the drive for Winter. Slezinski rolling out, being chased by Pennington. And then he's going to be brought down by Krause. He came up and made the play, upended Tanner Slezinski. But how about Henry Pennington in pursuit of Slezinski? Now Slezinski
on the carry.
Walking off, and he's favoring the left leg.
Brought down by number 17, Ryan Krause.
You hate to see that. We'll see if he's able to stay in or if Bloomfield Hills is going to, Slezinski's going to run back out there. How about Henry Pennington, though? He closed off
third
that angle
goal
that Slezinski was trying to get to, potentially touchdown or potentially close to the goal line. You don't lose much speed when he's in pursuit of running backs and quarterbacks at linebacker from Henry Pennington. Okay, here we go. Third and goal from the 8. Slezinski has it. This is for the tie. Slezinski rolling to his right, being chased. Coming up is Krause once again, and he brought him down. He brings him down at the 19. Ryan Krause on back-to-back plays blows it up for Bloomfield Hills. And now here's the decision.
Slezinski on the carry.
Maybe not much of one with 6:47 to go this deep
by number 90, Lev Metnikoff,
in Berkley territory with a quarterback like Tanner Slezinski.
Fourth down and goal.
You probably throw one up and hope for the best here. Ball is at the 16. Berkley just needs to have some guys around the goal line. But you got to watch for Shane Winter here. Obviously, you have to watch for Andrew Sapersky, who has 2 touchdowns in this football game. So Slezinski trips to the left. Rodriguez in the backfield. Slezinski looking, end zone. Sapersky knocked away! Knocked away, it was Ian Domzalski. With the wrap on his hand, again, stride for stride with Sapersky. And Berkley is going to get the football back.
Berkley takes over on downs.
Man coverage on the outside. Slezinski saw it But how about Ian Domzalski staying with it, knocks it away, great coverage, and Berkley is going to get the football back here, 6:09 to go. They may, if they're able to run the football, they'll be able to milk quite a bit of this thing. Obviously, they're going to try to.
First down and 10, Berkley.
How about Tanner Swazinski and the Bloomfield Hills offense right now? 0 points in this second half. They looked unstoppable in the first half. Maurice under center. Maurice to give to Peacher. Peacher shedding defenders. He's going to be drugged down all the way down to the 33. Pickup of 17, a good tough run there Peacher from Brandon the Peacher.
Brought down by number 6, C.J. Jackson.
Peacher with four receptions, in this game. One going for a touchdown.
17 on the play.
A good hard run there and a crucial
first down
on the drive for Berkley as they try to milk some clock. Remember, Hunter Robertson hit a 34-yard extra point. It was well good. So you have to imagine his range is a little bit beyond that. And they're going to get about four or so. They're going to mark him at the 40. Actually call it about six. So forward progress is going to mark him a little bit behind that, but it'll be second and four here for Berkley. So 5:20 to go. Bloomfield Hills has two timeouts.
Trying to carry.
They can stop it twice. But entering this half, up 21-14, getting the football back.
Second down and four.
But they've turned it over twice. One fumble, one interception. They punted. Got to credit the Berkley defense and the adjustments they made at halftime to swing this thing the way that they have. Here's Domzalski off the right side, and he is going to be brought down. And they got to stop forward progress at some point. They do there. So under 4:40 to go now. Huge third down coming up. We'll see if on the next series of downs, if Bloomfield Hills starts using those timeouts.
Domzalski on the carry, brought down by Jackson.
Berkley approaching.
Game three.
Not there yet.
Third down and one.
But starting to approach the area where they would just be able to melt the clock. Again, Bloomfield Hills can still stop it twice though. 28-21. It's been a good one here from Hurley Field tonight. Berkley trying to finish it off. Maurice under center. The give to Saris, and Saris off the left side. He has the first down and way more. Down to the 40. Pushed out of bounds inside the Bloomfield Hills 35-yard line.
Saris on the carry.
A big pickup. And that's a first down.
First down,
he goes out of bounds, so that stops the clock. Tell us our numbers. 28-yard run on the play there for Saris. Big game from him. Had that touchdown in the second quarter from 42 yards out. Has ran the football well all night long. Maurice. To give to Saris once again. He's brought down, and a nice stop there. That was 54. Brody Snyder on the stop.
Saris on the carry.
For Bloomfield Hills.
Brought down by Snyder.
So minimal gain there. He got nearly a yard.
Gain of one.
And Bloomfield Hills isn't going to use a timeout.
Second down and nine. So you
have
to 29.
You have to think it'll be on the next play. So ball at the 29. Berkley trying to seal the deal against Bloomfield Hills. Maurice under center with their backup quarterback. The gift to Ian Domzalski. Domzalski tried to reverse it inside. Nice job there by Joey Dorsch to wrap him up and make sure that one didn't get any farther. Brody Snyder was also in there for the Blackhawks.
Domzalski on the carry.
So 3:03. We have a clock stoppage. I don't know. And Bloomfield Hills did use a timeout. So it will be third and long.
The Bears will play at Hurley Field again next
Friday,
October 23rd,
Berkley,
as they play host to the Falcons of Rochester Hills High School. Game time is 7 p.m.
So, some scoring updates from around the area. Clarkston beating Birmingham Seaholm 35-7. That one is a final. Rochester, who will be here next week against Berkeley, they're leading Ferndale right now 40-16. How about the Lamphere Rams? They beat Clawson 64-0. Lamphere, in getting that win, they clinched the MAC bronze. So just in their first season without head coach Jeff Glenn. Glenn, a guy who a lot of people around the area liked. He's now at Walled Lake Western, and Lamphere, in their first year without him, they have clinched the MAC bronze. So good for Lamphere, as they had some tough years over the past decade or so, but they have clinched the MAC bronze. They did also a couple years ago with Glenn at the helm, but a nice job this year for the Rams. And how about that? 64-0 against Boston. When they clinched the MAC bronze a couple years ago, they weren't winning games quite like that. So impressive showing from the Rams tonight. Good to see. Good to see that program doing well. But we still have a big 3 minutes and 3 seconds here from Hurley Field. Berkeley trying to finish this thing off.
Third down and nine.
Third and nine. Bloomfield Hills has one timeout. Berkeley, at least in the formation, looks like they want to make them use that. A first down essentially ices the game. Maurice, the give to Liam Saris, and he is going to be brought down. Pickup of a couple. It's Snyder in again on the stop once again. Also in there for Bloomfield Hills was Zane Abdelhamid.
Service on the carry.
And that will bring up fourth down now, and we'll Snyder. Get a Bloomfield Hills timeout.
Bloomfield Hills calls timeout.
So it took some time as Berkeley was able to run a few minutes off the clock, but now the Bloomfield Hills defense, they do their job. And they're in a situation where it appears Tanner Slezinski is going to get the football. And right now I'm down on the track here for this one, and I'm watching Hunter Robertson, the kicker for Berkeley, took the balls out, and he may be going out to attempt the field goal here. He has joined the huddle. Right now on your screen, you're seeing the referees near the ball. But Hunter Robertson may be coming out to try a field goal. We're at the 29. It would be a 46-yard field goal from here. And he is. He is going out. We'll see if it's some type of ruse and they have a fake plan, or if they're going to try to get West or Bloomfield Hills with a hard count. But he is on the field. If he makes it from 46, that's game over. We'll see. We'll see what they do. He is in the game. He looked good from 34. This is only 12 more yards. It was well good from 34. We'll see if he has 12 more in him. So Bloomfield Hills, they're lined up to guard against any potential fake. This one ice it pretty much. 2:57, a big kick coming. They're going with the hard count. They're gonna go for the kick. It's blocked! It's blocked! It comes right back to Robertson, though, and it will be Bloomfield Hills football at their own 44. What a job by the Bloomfield Hills special teams. Didn't know if Berkeley was actually going to attempt that. They got fortunate with the ricochet. It went right back to the kicker, Robertson. And now, how about this? It's at the 35, not the 45. Or that'd be right at the 36. So Slezinski with 2:50 to go. They don't have any timeouts remaining, but plenty of time here.
From the 36.
And Slezinski's walking out with a limp. And that's one thing Berkeley's done really well in this second half is pressure Tanner Slezinski. We'll see if they're able to get to him here. Maybe a little less mobile than usual. So Slezinski, and now we're going to get a whistle, and we'll see who it's on. That's going to be offsides on the defense.
Against Berkeley.
So I'll make it first and five. Things getting interesting just a moment ago.
First down and five from the 41.
Berkeley had an opportunity make it a 10-point game. A 46-yard field goal attempt is blocked. Four wide here for Slezinski. He's in the gun. Play fake. Slezinski looking downfield, and that one is going to be caught. Caught. And he will go into the end zone. Touchdown. It is a touchdown for Bloomfield Hills. Unfortunately, 85's name isn't listed on the roster. I don't want to make any guesses. But a long touchdown. 59 yards, the fourth of the game for Slezinski. He'll be helped off the field. And Slezinski, don't like to speculate. And if you don't have him for overtime, you have to wonder if that's something that Dan Loria thinks about. He has his kicker out there. So plenty of time for Berkley now, though. 2:36, they have three timeouts left. So this is to tie it. Sarah Houston, 3-for-3 at extra points so far tonight. That one is up, and it is good. We are tied.
Attempt by Houston is good. With two minutes and 36 remaining in the fourth quarter, Bloomfield Hills 28.
So Slezinski, a 59-yard touchdown pass. And how about that? Just like that, we are tied once again. After the long touchdown. So that'll give it back to Berkley. Still a lot of time. 2:36 to go here from Hurley Field.
Blackhawks, number 16.
I'd like to thank those of you who have joined us here tonight on the live stream. This matchup has certainly lived up to the billing that it came with coming in. Jankowski's kick, and that one will go into the end zone, and will go out of the end zone, so we'll get a touchback, and that is where Zach Maurice and the Berkley offense will come out and try to win this game. So on a first and five, Tanner Slezinski finds his man, 59 yards. And we are tied.
First down and 10, Berkley.
Slezinski
from the 20.
Had a lot of trouble coming off the field. So for Bloomfield Hills, I thought maybe that would make Dan Loria think about trying for two. Put the pressure on Berkley a little bit. They elect to go for one. We don't know Slezinski's status or what is ailing him here tonight. So here's Maurice, three wide as he tries to get Berkley the win here at home. Maurice, the give over to Domzalski's brought down in the backfield. Leo Mina came up and made the stop. He's brought down at the 13, it's a loss of 7. That's going in the wrong direction if you're Berkley. However, they are in a situation where they can run this clock out and try and force overtime.
Loss of 7 on the play.
If things aren't going particularly well on this drive. 2 minutes to go exactly. You see the score, 28-28. It's been a great game here from Hurley Field. Zach Maurice has it. Zach Maurice looked to his left, now rolls to his right. Maurice takes off and he'll be pushed out of bounds. Berkley wanted the late hit. They won't get it. They won't get it. He was still running, fighting for extra yards. So good on the officials there to keep the flags in the pockets. And we play on. He went out of bounds, though. So 1:44 to go. He went out of bounds. Thus, they're unable to milk any more clock. And now we'll see what they elect to do here. 3rd and 16. You have an incompletion. Or maybe you call something that's just with one read. If that's not there, Maurice can just simply go down. We'll see what they came up with here. Four wide. Saris is in the slot to the left of Zach Maurice. Domzalski to the slot to the near side. Give to Peacher, and they are going to keep it on the ground. Nako for the first down. Ball's on the turf! Ball's on, though. They're going to rule him down. They're going to rule him down. I believe the officials discussing it now. Peacher coughed it up. The line judge initially said down, and it looks like they're going to stick with that. Berkley doesn't have a timeout, so they will have to give the football back over to Bloomfield Hills. They can't milk all of it. Obviously, will be crucial for Hunter Robertson to get a good punt off. And I think Bloomfield Hills may want a timeout. What a turn of events, both ways. Both ways in this game. As fun as the first half was, the back and forth here in this second, as Berkeley's going to run that as far as they can. You see it? Or you don't see it. 46 seconds remaning. They're going to have to punt it from deep in their own territory, right at the 10. And Tanner Slezinski is going to come back out with an opportunity to win this game for Bloomfield Hills. Quick scoring recap. Things started today. Slezinski, 24-yard touchdown pass to Sapersky. Liam Saris in the second quarter. That was in the first quarter. Liam Saris in the second quarter had a 42-yard touchdown run. PAT was good. That made it 7-7. Bloomfield Hills, though, they came right back as they did throughout all of that first half. Tanner Slezinski found Andrew Sapersky again. This time it was a 30-yard touchdown pass. Extra point was good. That made it 14-7. Ian Domzalski and the Berkeley Bears responded, though. It was a 15-yard run. PAT was good. That made it 14-14. Right before the half, Slezinski found Shayus Qureshi on a 7-yard touchdown. That made it 21-14. Get to the second half scoring in a moment. Big punt here for Hunter Robertson. Made that huge extra point to give or to tie the game earlier, and that punts off, and that one is a decent one. It's going to take a Bloomfield Hills bounce, though, and die at the 39 of Berkeley. So 35 seconds left, and the Bloomfield Hills offense is coming back out onto the field. And last time we saw Slezinski, he had to be helped off. He comes onto the field here, of course, under his own power.
First down and 10, Blackhawks.
21-14, though, and then we had the touchdown for Berkeley, the Peacher screen pass. That made it 21-21. And then it was John Coleman had the pick six. That made it 28-21, Berkeley. Here's Slezinski looking deep for Sapersky, and he overshot him. Man in coverage there was Jake Domzalski. And then to tie the game, Slezinski, a 59-yard touchdown pass, number 85. Was the player
second down
who caught
10.
That. I wish he was on this roster sheet so I could say who it was and give him his proper credit. It was an incredible play. It tied the game, and now 30 seconds, second and 10. Not sure what their options are as far as a field goal kicker. Sarah Houston is 4-for-4 on extra points here tonight. And then number 16, Oscar Jankowski, the junior, he does the kickoffs. So maybe on a deeper shot, he would come into the game. 30 seconds to go, no timeouts for Bloomfield Hills. We are tied. Slezinski looking deep, right side. He just lofts it up, and it's intercepted! It's intercepted! And it was Colin Linehan who has it. And for the moment, it at least preserves a chance in overtime for the Berkeley Bears.
Pass intercepted by number 16, Colin Lynham.
And he fell, tripped, couldn't set himself and get going the other way. Try and get a return. May have had a convoy up that left sideline had he been able to maintain his balance. He goes to the ground, though, and now we have a situation where you have to think they'll just run it out. They do have two timeouts, so if you break one, if you break this off, maybe you use one, and Try to see what you can do with a shot downfield or a Hunter Robertson field goal. Right now, they're deep in their own end at the 14, though. How about Slezinski, though? His second turnover of the game, second interception. He fumbled once. It was picked up by his own team, though. Here's Saris going up the field now. Saris is going to be brought down at the 19. So pick up a 5.
Berkley calls timeout.
And we will get a Berkley timeout. So there it is. You look, get a look at the score here from Hurley Field, 28-28. The ball is actually on the Berkley side. It says Bloomfield Hills here on that scoreboard. But Berkley right now with the football, it looks as if they're going to be content to run it out. But we look like we're headed for overtime here from Hurley Field. It's been a good game, a back-and-forth football game. It was all Berkley in the third quarter, and then Bloomfield Hills storms back here in the fourth. They get it tied 28-28. After trailing 28-21, Berkley scored the first 14 points of this second half, had the football, looked like they were going to be poised to try and ice it or try and run the clock out. They had it in Bloomfield Hills territory. We're up 7, but the Bloomfield Hills defense got the stop. They blocked the Robertson field goal, and then Tanner Slezinski came down and made the big throw. 28-28. Play fake from Zach Maurice. Maurice looking downfield, overshoots his man, and it's going to fall harmlessly to the turf. But a scary play there. So 10 seconds to go.
Maurice's pass intended for Domzalski is incomplete.
If I'm Berkley, with the way Slezinski has thrown it down the field with Sapersky and Winter and the capability that those guys have shown in making the big catch and going up and getting, no matter where it's placed, I may be running this one out here. 10 seconds to go. We'll see what they elect to do. So 3rd and 5, 10 seconds. 18-yard line, Maurice under center. Give is to Ian Domzalski. Domzalski with space up the middle, and he's going to break a tackle. Domzalski still going, brought down at the 31, and they will use their final timeout. Clock stops with 2 seconds. So they are 69 yards away from winning the football game.
Domzalski on the carry, brought down by Jordan.
Here with 2 seconds, they will use a timeout. So we look like we are headed
from the 31
for overtime here from Hurley Field. And I'll take, again, this opportunity to look at some scores in the area. Macomb County, Grosse Pointe South, and Sterling Heights-Stevenson, they're having one kind of like this. They're tied up at 35, 5 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Sterling Heights-Stevenson and Grosse Pointe South. Stony Creek beats Southfield A&T 36-7. South Lyon beats Milford 31-7. Riverview beat Grosse Hill 60-29. The Livonia rivalry. Livonia Churchill beats Livonia Stevenson 24-20. Good one there. How about this one? Dakota Romeo. Dakota up 34-28. 56 seconds left in the fourth quarter there. That big time rivalry out in Macomb County. Okay, here we go. Last play of regulation, unless there's a defensive penalty. Maurice gets the snap. Maurice looking, nowhere to go with it, and he's going to be brought down. Did a good job just holding on to that football. There were 3 Blackhawks in the area. So, 48 minutes, not enough to settle it here from Hurley Field. We'll have overtime at the other end of this break. We're tied at 28. Stay with us on CMNtv. And hello and welcome back, everybody, here from Hurley Field, Bloomfield Hills and Berkley, getting set to do battle in overtime. I'm David Hughes, joining you tonight from Hurley Field, and it's been a really good one. A back and forth game. We came in to this second half, and Bloomfield Hills was getting the football, and then Berkley kind of through what they were able to do themselves defensively, but they were able to take advantage of those Bloomfield Hills turnovers. We had one Tanner Slezinski fumble, and then that big pick six from John Coleman. That was early fourth quarter, that pick six. Made it 28-21, and it looked for a moment as if Berkley was going to ride that momentum and come away with a win here at home against Bloomfield Hills. But the Bloomfield Hills defense got a huge stop on fourth down, a blocked field goal, and then that led to a 59-yard touchdown through the air from Tanner Slezinski. It was his fourth touchdown of this game. He has turned it over twice, and that allowed Berkley back into the football game in the second half, but a big-time play from Slezinski. And that was what you feared, I think, if you were Berkley when you gave him the football back with that amount of time left. But they're able to get a stop again on the last drive for Slezinski, and now we are set here to do battle in overtime. Berkley and Bloomfield Hills talked all night about how hyped up this one was coming in, and it's certainly been as advertised as it's Wrigley. And Slezinski out there to take the point to us. And they flip it twice, I'm not sure. They'll flip it and it's going to go over to Bloomfield Hills. Imagine they'll be playing defense first. They're sorting things out. You see Slezinski, number five, still favoring that leg a little bit, has a wrap on it. So Bloomfield Hills will be going in net, and now they're going to reverse and point in the other direction. So the coin toss is finally complete. Wrigley and Slezinski come together, a couple of talented guys there, certainly. Looks like Berkley, or Bloomfield Hills, excuse me, will be playing defense first. So winner of this game, if it's Berkley, of course they move to 5-0. Big matchup with Rochester next week. For Bloomfield Hills, they will host Avondale next week. So you get this one tonight, you have to like your chances against Avondale. No disrespect to Avondale. They're just not having a great season this year. They're doing battle tonight with Royal Oak. That is out at Dick By Field out in Auburn Hills. Nice facility that is. So we are going down to the far end zone, at least from my vantage point, as these two teams continue to get ready for overtime. So 28-28. Some of the major stories in this game, the offenses were going at a rapid pace in that first half, especially on the Bloomfield Hills side. They were not stopped, 3-for-3, scoring touchdowns on all of their possessions. They only got three possessions because Berkley ran the football so well. That three-headed attack with Saris, Domzalski, and Peacher. And we haven't even seen a ton of Jake Domzalski tonight. He is one of their better weapons as well. So on both of these teams, you have multiple guys who can beat you, multiple guys who are big-time
Berkley
players.
Will begin overtime first. First down and 10.
So here we go. We are
check
underway.
First down goal from the 10.
And high school overtime rules, you start from the 10. So it's Zach Maurice. They'll go with the power formation. Maurice under center. Maurice. Play fake. Look, rolling to his right now. Looking for Saris out in the flat. He has him, and he will go in. Touchdown, Berkley. Liam Saris, a beautiful play call there, just a play action boot, and Zach Maurice executes it to perfection, finding Saris. It's Saris' second touchdown of the game, this one from 10 yards out on the reception, second throwing touchdown for Zach Maurice here for the Berkley Bears. So Robertson will now come out for the extra point. Try and give Berkley a 7-point lead. Zalski on to hold. Robertson on extra points has been perfect. Did have a field goal get blocked. It was a 46-yard attempt. Snap down. Kick is up, and it's blocked again! It's blocked again, and now a window has opened up for Bloomfield Hills.
Extra point attempt by Robertson is no good.
Hunter Robertson, who was perfect all night tonight. They did have a special teams issue last week, but it ended up working out. There was a bad snap, but Jake Domzalski was able to pick it up and go in for a two-point conversion against Troy Athens. It ended up winning them the football game. But now they are here. They had an extra, or a field goal that would have iced it to make it 31 to 21, excuse me. That would have iced it. It was 46 yards. I don't know. Robert, his kick did look really good from 34, so he probably has the leg for 46. I'm sure his coach has an idea of what his range is too. So that one's blocked, and then this is blocked, and now Berkley winning by just six, and Bloomfield Hills with a touchdown and extra point would win this football game. So here we go. Slezinski, they have four plays to make it 10 yards. If they're able to do that, an extra point for the win. Slezinski being pressured, rolling to his right, almost brought down, looking to the end zone. It is caught! Caught for a touchdown by Berkley, and it was number three for Berkley, Shayus Qureshi. His second of the game from 10 yards out. And now Bloomfield Hills is an extra point away from inflicting heartbreak here on the Berkley Bears at home. The scoreboard, 34-34. We have zeros in the first overtime. Robertson had his extra point blocked. Sarah Houston to try and win it. It's down, it is up, and it is good! It's good! The Blackhawks mob the field as they pull one out here at Hurley Field. Berkley players, devastation on their side. How about Sarah Houston?
Hurley Field this evening, the Blackhawks.
Five for five on extra points. And none bigger than that last one to make it 35-34. An absolute incredible game here tonight from Berkley.
Game time is 7 p.m.
So your final 35-34. Started out pretty much how we expected. Tanner Slezinski did his thing. Three touchdowns in that first half. He ends up with five for the game. Berkley early on, they got that run established. They did a nice job. It was 21-14 after the first half. We headed to the second half, thinking that Slezinski would keep things rolling. He was unable to, though, had a couple of turnovers through that big pick six, but credit him and the Bloomfield Hills team. They responded nicely, showing that resilience, getting that stop, getting that long touchdown when they needed it to tie the game, and then in overtime, they get their second blocked field goal attempt. This one was on a PAT. The previous one was on a field goal, and then Slezinski finds Qureshi for his second touchdown of the game, and then Sarah Houston along with Slezinski, the two heroes of the night, as Houston drills the extra point to send Bloomfield Hills home winners 3-2. Again, they will be hosting Avondale next week, and then a big one here again at Berkley next week as they will be hosting high-powered Rochester. So that will do it here from Hurley Field. Once again, an incredible game. I'd like to thank everybody who joined us, whether it was on the live stream, CMNtv, your final. Bloomfield Hills 35, Berkley 34. Thank you and have a great night.